This world is not my home, I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. I have a loving mother just over in glory land, and I don't expect to stop until I shake her hand. She's waiting now for me in heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Just over in glory land we'll live eternally. The saints on every hand are shouting victory. Their songs of sweetest praise drip back from heaven's shore, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon.
I do not know what say per gare dollars. Nobody knows how you feel. And God knows. Therefore, offer it up to you.
And yet, on my city again, Lord God, it makes you up. Have on my city again. Have on my city again. Have on my city again, Lord God, it makes you up. Have on my city again, I reckon that. Chuku ne me ma, ebo ma serege, no gade la ne tua. Ebo ma serege, ebo ma serege, ebo ma serege, no gade la ne tua. Ebo ma serege, o ma serege. If it pleases God that by this time, our brother Judah will be lying motionless. If it pleases you that Judah will die shortly after his mother-in-law, it pleases us because we cannot change what you have planned. But we ask you for one thing, the courage, the fortitude to handle this.
No matter how long. There is nothing we can do
to question God. But in every situation, we must find a reason
to say thank God.
In as much as
this is a double tragedy. Inasmuch as this is so painful, we see how to find a reason to give more. It will not be as long as it be, one time again, again, and as it be. We have all come today
to accord him the final respect as a good man that he was, as the man known for peace. We have all come today to say goodbye to our brother that we shall all see again and never to depart. He has run his race. Whatever left now is for us to live. God is the only one who understands why things happen. Nobody ever does. I was privileged to meet him the very last time, I think, December 31st or January 1,
as in Paris,
Paris Schumacher. That was December 31st. And I have personally come today to say thank you. Because during the harvest Thanksgiving, he bought me a color note
for 50,000 naira. He said, we wrote to him a father for 50,000. I was in the altar. And I'm saying thank you. There is a saying that goes, when you spend your time chasing butterflies, butterflies will run away, and you end up with nothing.
But when you build a beautiful garden, butterflies will come to fetch in your gardens. Even when they come,
you still have your garden. You spend his time
building
very nice garden. As men, all of us to be here today. If you don't know him, or if you were not privileged to meet him when every connection. Ne mara kasi jodo lora ko. Onwe boni ibona ase waju ajom mara lori o. Do you know that, right? So say si bom mara kana ase ko lora go, right? Pero una na yo ba yo, which we don't believe as Catholics. That is nothing like that. But that is to tell you the extent of a good man he was. But today, it pleases God that you must be bad. We are crying because we miss it. But at the same time, God planned this in his own way. There is no way this moment could have been avoided. No way. God said, no, I don't want you to die in Nigeria. I want you to die when you get back. Because if he had died in Nigeria, too many speculations, too many worries, his death probably could have attracted a lot of enemies. There could have been suspicion of other things. Who knows who killed him? But nobody killed anybody. Because you don't take what you don't tell, what you didn't take.
I know in your mind you would have been saying, if I had known, I would have acted differently. That is what we can say as human beings.
I'll ask you to just wipe away your tears. And I will also give you the credit. Because the two most important people in her life, left and center, her mother and her husband, whom she described after going through many processes in marriage, finally she settled to call him daddy. You know, before a woman could go through the process in marriage, and now coming to conclusion that my husband will be my dad,
she must have overcome a lot of
trials. And Ijoma survived all these challenges and finally decided that you have moved from being my husband, from being my mother, and now come to the last bastard, which is my dad.
The last of it all.
And God is saying at this time, I will be your dad. Because I am greater than you. Because God must replace what is taken from you. There is no way he will continue to leave you with these tears running down your eyes. I don't believe so. From my ministry, I know
the moments like this, that's when I was frequented.
I ask you to still hang in there. I will change it. A woman said, instead of saying hang in there, you say hang in the loop.
I will not hang in there
because sometimes you might get tired and give up. Ijoma, I ask you to please hang in the Lord. That is the only one who will make this thing that doesn't make sense to you. Nobody will ever convince you.
I'm saying this because I've been this way all the time. No matter what you say, God will speak to you
when the time comes. So far, you are doing well. And we ask you to continue to well. And if there is one more thing or one last thing your father will say to all of you, he will say,
Son,
daughter, and son, behold your mother.
Leslie, you are now the two that we all see and know. The mantle of leadership in her has fallen on your shoulders. You now, the man of the house, behold your mother. Make sure that this tears does not continue to run down.
Behold your mother. Make sure you do not make her remember the death of her husband every day. Make sure you do not allow these tears to continue to run down. Behold your mother.
Do not make sure that these tears keep running down every day.
Anything you know that will make
her remember the wound,
don't do. Anything you know, your mind tells you that when you do this, mommy will cry because the daddy is not here, don't do. You have to help your mother to heal. You have to carry this together.
There is one thing more profound saying that you brother.
You all have to unite together. The pain and the loss of your father will continue to be when you begin to separate from each other. But when you all stay together, you will not feel the pain so much. When you get a broom, and even more profound say that as it's an unknown, my general, right? Then when you have a data in pieces,
it is one
very easy to break. What cannot break you will make you stronger. You have to stay together.
You have to look out for each other. Your father will never die if you still carry him with you.
Remember, the second reading today says, nothing will ever separate you from the love
that you have for your father. Death.
I do tell people that there are two different types of death. One is the physical death, and the second one is the death in the mind of the being. When your loved one dies in you, that is the worst death. But when your loved one still remains and lives in you, even when he or she is no more,
death has no power over you. It is simple dangerous.
Moving from life mortal to immortal life.
Therefore,
you all have to make sure that your husband still remains in you. You all have to make sure that your father still lives in you. You know, Igbo culture has a way or tried in different ways to please death. So that death will leave us alone.
But that didn't work. Igbo culture has different names.
Such as Songu Biko, Onwa Mebu, Onwa Mese,
Onwu Chekwa, Onwu Zuigbo, Onwu Biko. But in all these things, Onwu said, you know what?
No, I am on a mission
that must be accomplished. There is nothing we can do
to stop
when death comes. I will tell you one story of what happened. There was a man very wealthy. This man had a lot of money. He never wanted to die. One day it was time for him
dying, and Mr. Dent came to his house. But this man, remember, he was a very stingy man, but worthy. So when Mr. Dent came, he tried to lobby Dent to leave him alone. What he did was to go and buy a very nice wine. What he did was to go and prepare a very delicious food. Then when Dent came to his house, he served him food, served him drink. Mr. Dent ate food and drank and was drunk and fell asleep in his house. The man said, okay, I am going to do what Nigerian politicians do best. I will lobby Mr. Dent so that he will not kill me. So when Mr. Dent was asleep, this man took the list, saw his name as the next person to die. What he did was to cross out his name and now went to the last of the list and wrote his name. You know, that was very smart of him, right? Did you get the story? Now let me repeat that. When Mr. Dead Adam was drunk, Mr. Dead has a list. He's going from house to house, taking people at different times. That was the moment for this man to die. But when he came to this man's house, the man gave him food and drunk him. Now took the list and crossed his name out as the next person to go. Now went to the last of the list and wrote his name. So when Mr. Dent woke up from sleep, he didn't find out. He said to him, can I shake your hand? But you're not going to die. He said, I want to thank you very graciously for giving me this food that I have not ate before and this wonderful and expensive wine. Because of your hospitality, because of your kindness, I have come to take you, but I will skip your name and now start from the bottom of the list. The man said, what have I done? That was the moment it dawned on him that it is time. There is nothing he could have done to escape that moment. When it is time, it is time. It could happen back to back, but when it's time, it is time. Our brother died because that was the time. That was the time I had a funeral of a 19-year-old boy who came on vacation to New Jersey from France. That was one of the toughest ones. You took your kids from your station to a different place on a vacation, and one of them died there. And I asked the mother, do you think your son wouldn't have died if you didn't come on this vacation? She didn't have an answer. But the answer is, only God knows. It could happen anytime. While on transit, while sleeping, while eating, while sleeping. Therefore, the best thing we can do for ourselves right now is to find a way to be ready. Settle your differences. God is not interested in how much you have in your bank account. He is not interested in the neighborhood where you live. He is not interested in your careers. He is not interested in your titles. He is not interested in the kind of clothes we wear. He is only interested in one thing, your relationship with each other. That is why when somebody dies, he said the hands will be kept like this. Nothing will be in your hands. Even when you hold your checkbook so tight, I remember one man in the emergency room, he held his checkbook. But when situation came, became so tough, the checkbook fell off his hand. He became powerless. This is where God defined himself, that I am the all and all. I am the owner of life. I will give it and I will take it when I want. I do not need your permission to call you back. Somebody could go to the best hospital and still die. Somebody could be in the best medical practitioner's hands and see one dies. Because the owner has spoken. Therefore, whatever you can do to be the best man that will make people come when you die, do it now. Remember, I told you at the beginning that when you spend your time chasing butterflies, butterflies will run away. But when you spend your time making beautiful gardens, butterflies will be attracted. Whether good or bad, butterflies will come. For Jews to pull people out from different states, on a Friday afternoon, he built a wonderful garden. Therefore, my dear friends, the only opportunity and time we have is now. Don't wait till tomorrow. When Jude boarded the plane and was coming back, somebody was at the airport waiting to pick him up. Unfortunately, he didn't come out the way the person expected. It could be anyone. And for his mother-in-law to die, and shortly after he died, is a simple coincidence. There is nothing responsible for that. That is how it is designed to be. You know, because sometimes we try to begin to look for something where there is nothing, wasting our time and resources. Please, when it happens, it happens. I remember one day, family was coming back and had an accident. This is a life story. Everybody in the vehicle died and only one child left. The whole person in that vehicle died. That child lived to testify to the mission of God, to the goodness of God. Yao, Joma, China Kenya Watajawa Kanye Mbasoje Guya. I'm very confident that God will see you through with your children and to all the family members. It is tough, but with God, you will pull through to it. Therefore, may the soul of our brother Jude, and even the soul of his mother-in-law, Hilda, rest in perfect peace. Amen. God bless you.
Now and leading over the waters of death, we pray. showed mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them into the eternal kingdom of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you, the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
The family and friends of Jude and Judah seek comfort and consolation. Hear their pain and dispel the darkness, and out they come from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
When I assembled here in faith and confidence to pray for our brother Jude and our sister Hilda, strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of the Son's coming. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of the people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ, especially Jude, Anubi, and Hildozawa, and grant them a place in the kingdom through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. So that your departed servants, Jude and Hilda, may be taken up into glory with your Son. In those great mystery of love, we are all united through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is to the right and just that is in salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. From the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will give it all for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take these, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the eternal covenant, which we pour out for you for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your servant Jude and Hilda, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
On behalf of the family of St. Matthias, I want to sincerely thank all of you for coming together to pray for our brother Jude, our sister Hilda, who continue to hold and lead each other and the entire family in prayers. It's a difficult time, but God is present in our lives. That is the most important thing at this point. Let me also welcome my brother Peter, Reverend Father Peter Iwala, and to thank him for that reflection. At this point, I would like to invite the brother of Jude, Christopher Anyibi, to please come and thank those of God to pray for your brother.
Good evening, everybody.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
We shall joyfully greet him again in the love of Jesus Christ.
honestly, it's hard this every single day. Like I keep thinking, like every single day, I keep thinking this isn't happened. But even seeing his body, I'm reminded, like, he may have left us physically, but at least he's kept us here spiritually. And just that, even if, like, he's not still there with us, he's at least watching over us as much as he can. He's our entire family. And just, in God's name, just hopefully, if he finds us, works out. Because in the end, at least we're all still together as a family. Even work things out, even with that, at least with him watching over us now.
We thank thee each morning for a newborn day, where we may work the fields of new mown hay. We thank thee for the sunshine and the air that we breathe, O Lord. We thank thee. Thank thee for the rivers that run all day. Thank thee for the little birds that sing along the way. Thank thee for the trees and the deep blue sea, O Lord. We thank thee. Oh yes, we thank thee, Lord, for every flower that blooms, birds that sing, fish that swim, and the light of the moon. We thank thee every day as we kneel and pray, that we were born with eyes to see these things. Thank thee for the fields where the clover is grown. Thank thee for the pastures where cattle may roam. Thank thee for thy love so pure and free, O Lord. We thank thee.
Because today is basically not a very good day for all of us. Unfortunately, one of our own brother, a husband to Dr. I.J. Anyibe, a friend to many colleagues, we are here today to mourn in the name of Prince Chief. Oh my goodness, this man, Anya Nolora, December Garaka, Jude Chidi Anyibe. Unfortunately, we had a very bad news before we came back from Nigeria. He passed on a very, very young age of 65. May his soul rest in peace in Jesus' name. Our condolences to you and your family. Our condolences to you.
Let this best assurance come true.
Crying no more. Oh, his word, his melody.
Yes, the immediate family, the wife and kids, is now seated. Please, it is also my pleasure to introduce to all of us daughter, relatives that will be helping us over there. And in the lead will be Chiefs Chris and Ibe. Please, all other family members, this is the time for you to come over here and have your seat, please. Yes, sir. These are the extended family members. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, we have gathered here tonight to celebrate the life of one of our own. The man that you called home at a time you planned to call him back home. A man that we mostly needed, but you said no, you need him. A man who was so dear to many. A man who reached out to many in different ways that we cannot question you. We ask you to please accept him in your paradise. We ask you to please bless and console his family. We ask you to please wipe away the tears from the eyes of his wife. We ask you to please be the father to his children. We ask you to please console all that are affected. There is nothing else we can do than to do what we're doing now, to say goodbye to a good man. And to all of us who have gathered, we have come from different places, we thank you for granting us journey mercies. Help us to remain connected with you. Help us to always remain connected with each other. And may the Almighty God who has brought us here tonight bless and continue to guide us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Important. Praise Leslie. Over to my brother.
Ibo Quen.
Yeah.
Ibo Quen.
Yeah.
So right now we're about to do the presentation, the call that. I'm going to pass it over to my eldest, Uncle Christopher.
Yes, sir. I see the other boy. I big uncle. Prince, chief. And you be, what's the burrow like? Over to you, sir.
Igbo Queen.
Yeah.
Igbo Queen.
Yeah.
Quezon. Mr. Biko, thank you very much. Here, what men are, what nation, you're with you, Queen. Biko, on the way, you have been here. You have the Hennigia, or Jenna Jankin. However, I didn't have been here. So, in there, as a company, on this year, on my Cambona, this is my brother Scorpia, this is here to remember. So, one year. Okay. Biko.
Ọchị ihe ndakwasa ọ gaghị aga ije mana a sị na eri atọ nwere atụrụ ọsọ gịrịgịrị onye anọ. The National President of Umuaka National Union is here. Dr. Chief Favour Awuzu, biko bịarịrị ya. And also Rico Kelo Kelendi Braba.
Ibo Kelen. Aka Gwen.
Yeah.
Olu Gwen.
Yeah.
Ibo Gwen.
Yeah.
Nigeria Gwenzon. Biko, just one thing. The reason nje si onwo na nga bi ebe ata wo na at the end of ihe ni line eme no wa also ofu ihe ora iruru no wa ka ga eje cheta ai. And I crave your indulgence, I have a very bad voice, but in tribute to Prince Chief Jude Chida Ibe. Aga madi ka baba ndu kututu kela buru banya wuwara otu aga ike wesi n'olu wankana nani olu ai ka geji cheta. Biko, for your information, onya na aba mmadu, the success of Umuaka National Union Convention 2022 na this Baltimore was because of his resilience, and that should go to his credit. Alive or dead, that should go to his credit. I want the record to remember him for that. Because again, Nima Ihia Gina Aleji cheki e onwo to si meji Chineke kpo gi kedi ha ga eje echete gi.
RDC isi obi a mmadụ niile bịara nke a ekele dịrị ọnụ n'ọnụ nwanyị zaghị oku onye anyị kwere n'ihi ịgbakọ n'ebe ebe a today bụ Chief Prince Jude Anyebe, we are the immediate board chairman of Ono Regional Assembly, Washington DC. So, mana dịka Pastor Father kwuru, nwanne m nwoke agụkwa n'abụ, laịfụ anyị nọ n'ime o nwere onye mma echi. Ebe ndị nwere onye mara echi, ọ pụtara na onye ọbụla ga-adị na njikere na mgbe ọbụla a kpọrọ ya ọ ga-ala n'udo ejikwe n'ihe ọma wee na-echeta onye ahụ. Anyị niile bịara nga taa, onye na-ala onwe onye na ibe na-ese okwu na na-adọgbusi onwe ha na-ekọ isi na-enweghị isi na ọda ga-akwụsị n'ụbọchị taa n'ihi na ụwa ya onwe n'ebe e ji ya aga. At the end, death is the price to pay for living. Ndewonu. Ọrụ
USA.
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 I'm standing here this evening on behalf of Ora USA National President, Dr. Uzo Uluibu, who is currently in Nigeria on an unplanned visit. He'll be coming back on Sunday. I know the wife, our first lady, Titi, is here, and the Ora women are here represented. I know Ora will come and do a presentation here later. But on behalf of members of Ora USA, again, this is not a trip any one of us had planned for. But unfortunately, by the call of nature, we are all here. For those of you that may not know, Chief Prince Jude Anibe and his lovely wife hosted us on our last day of a medical mission. That's the picture a lot of people from Ora that are not from Omaki have of him. They hosted us lavishly in their home in Owerri. Fortunately for me, but unfortunately today, I was the one that presented the cola on behalf of the family because of my relationship. Nobody would have believed we'll be here today mourning my cousin. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed rest in peace.
Thank you, Abedike. Biko, in addition, Unumana, Onya Anekwu, old Chief Prince Jude Anibe, one year not here. Now, one year lose good and Maya. So, Uruga only here about many angles. So, Mna about Chief Eziama. Chief Eziama. Kobia. Gideon Eziama. One day. Ekelenge. On behalf of Ndeziama, MC, a big girl, can I reach a fool? biko nchetakwa na Chief Prince Jude Anyibe was the immediate past president of Akan National Union, both Maryland, Washington DC and Virginia. He handed over to me last August. So all is very dear to us, and our commitment to him is 100%. Mr. MC, thank you.
Biography, that's the way in at this moment. Okay, sorry, I not talk things, I don't need to talk here, so I'm afraid I have to read it. Okay, so please give me your audience and indulge me for a couple of minutes. Okay, Chief Prince Jude Anyibe is the son of the late Chief Sir Emmanuel and Lord Lady Margaret Anyibe, and was born on January 16th, 1959. In the home time of Open Market in Norwegian State. He grew up with six siblings, many relatives and friends, very well loved, and acquired several honors, including getting the name Prince, as he was always been called. He attended elementary school and then completed high school in St. Mary's School, Umuakan, with upper class. He entered and finished auxiliary teachers college degree at the Ihiala Nwa, a local government in Abuja State. After teaching teachers college in Nigeria, he became the lecturer in technical school, high school in Umuakan for 3 years before he relocated to the United States of America, which became his home base for the rest of his life until death. While he lived in the United States of America to make his life a fruitful one, he worked and attended school concurrently. He completed his bachelor's degree in business administration at the University of British Columbia, Washington, D.C., with honors. While continuing to work, he entered back to school and completed his master's degree. On satisfying his mission, he proceeded to achieve his next goal and got married, to whom he loved and always called her mommy after his mother's death. He wedded and his wife joined him from Nigeria, USA, to start a new life as a couple, where they have lived together for 30 years with four lovely children from 20 years and above. During his married life, he played a tremendous role as a husband, father, sibling, uncle, and in-law. His in-laws welcomed him very dearly as a family, and were there for him, protecting him and his family. He never had an issue with his lovely wife and children. He was always there for his wife as a husband and for his children and as a father. He always cherished and clung to his wife and never took her for granted, and handled her like a queen or a princess. The entire family has tirelessly missed him, and this vacuum he created will never replace the life of his entire family. Chief Prince Jude Anyibe was indeed a tiger as Ochasin Nagirigowan, who worked in several buildings as a security officer at the beginning of his arrival in the United States. And while in the University of British Columbia, he proceeded to securing a state government job at the Maryland State Department of Corrections, where he spent more than 20 years of the rest of his life with several promotions and awards until his last day. Chief Prince Jude Anyibe was an immediate past president of his hometown meeting, the ANOU Market Committee, Maryland, Virginia, and DC, Athlete Branch, for 6 years, and just handed over to the current president a few months ago. He contributed a lot to his community. Through his leadership, he raised a lot of funds at the local ANOU meeting and spearheaded the hosting of ANOU National Convention for the Community, where he probably raised a good amount of funds with the mission to help with home security in his community. He also was involved and contributed to some community school renovations in his home school, which is still going on. He was a founding member of the Olori General Assembly, Washington, D.C., RIDC, where he served from 2006 till his death. He was the first financial secretary of RIDC for 4 years. He became a board member in the next regime for another 4 years, and finally board chairman of ORA-DC till then. He was an IT member of ORA-ESN National Body. He did not stop there, but equally supported his wife, Dr. Joma, who had been the ORA-DC Affairs Medical Mission representative for 12 years. He hosted the ORA-USN National Medical Mission team in his house just a few weeks before his death and transit to ESL, as he was returning back to ESL, which was his last achievement. Before his death, his last outing were his sister's daughter's wedding and also the other sister's wedding in Nigeria. Friends, chieftaincy events, and his in-law Knight of Columbus light event in Asante Cathedral of Ware. Chief Prince Jude Ayimbe was a quiet, peaceful man, a loving husband, a father, a destiny helper to so many, a potential the true officer to the United States of America, Maryland Department of Corrections. Farewell, Prince Jude Ayimbe. We miss you. May your soul continue to rest in perfect peace. Amen. This was presented by Dr. Joma Ayimbe, his wife. Please, thank you very much for being patient with me and MC.
Thank you so much. A pleasure. Put your hands together for me. Thank you. Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I am going to hand the microphone over to the first son of our departed brother, Prince Leslie Ayimbe. Thank you.
Well, first I have to say thank you all for coming, condolences, the praises, the faith, and everything. It's not easy. It's really not. It's going to be a challenge every day, every single day from here on out, to support not only my brothers and sisters, but also my mom, in order to keep the happiness in our family going. For my father, he's been there with me every single day. I had no problems with him. Obviously, the families have the occasional little fights in my head. But nothing could describe this man, what he's done for me at all, every single day. He has provided for this family, for me, for my brothers, for my sister, every single day, for as long as I can live, from since I was born. So now, he has been the greatest figure ever in my life and will always continue to be. He may have left us physically, but he's still with us here spiritually. I will never ever forget that. I may not want to think about it every single day from now, but I'll never forget it for the rest of my life. No one will ever interfere with what he has done for me and my family, ever. And, whole course of years, for as long as I can seem to live, he will always be there in my heart. He will never, ever be forgotten through his brothers, through his sisters, through his entire family, through everyone here. And I hope that everything just continues to be that way, that he continues to watch over us in the name of God. I just hope he
Now we are going to hand the mic over to the princess of the house. Princess Ayimbe, over to you there.
I am still in shock to this day that you are no longer with us in body. I still wonder every other day if a voice speaking from downstairs in our living room includes you. And I've just been dreaming the whole thing this whole time, only for me to wake up and unfortunately realize that you aren't here. It's just a TV playing, or a video on a phone that I'm hearing, or someone else being on the phone, and I have to come back to reality. However, I'll always remember all of the days you were able to say good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night. Your fatherly humor would never fail to make me smile, even when I wasn't in the mood to be positive. Your advice for navigating the world, being steadfast, making sure to be prompt, try your best to do everything to the best of our abilities, be concise in what we want to do and say, all of that, we still find its way to the back of my mind in everything that we do. And I'll continue to take in your energy to exist in this world as the best me that I can be. I will honor your name, your time, your presence, by continuing to help be there for the family in ways that I am able. I have no doubt that you will give me the strength to experience life and the world as it should be without consequence, burden, or suffering. Even though you're not here in body, I will always keep you here in spirit, as I know you have and always will. Watch over us and protect us in heaven, as you did on earth. Rest in glory, peace, and tranquility. You deserve it for being the best dad that you could ever be. Thank you.
Thank you. Our brother that left us is well grounded. Okay, so now we are going to the office of Prince Michael. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, and thank you all for being here today. It means a lot, all your support and love. I'm not that good with words either, so I hope my writing can do justice for my feelings that I have toward everything that my father has done for us. It still doesn't feel real. So many times I thought that he would simply come back to us, smiling like always. So many times I thought that the next day he would be there to say good morning. So many times I thought that all this pain would just fade away and we would all return to being a big, happy family again. I hoped, I believed, I wished. I still do, but the reality is clear, as far as I'm ready to accept. It will do no good wallowing in sorrow, grasping at the past. God has a different path for us than we expected, and we owe it to ourselves to see it through. But it wouldn't hurt. Moreover, I take comfort in remembering what you gave us. Your jokes made me smile and laugh, how you always checked up on me to see if I was okay, even soulless. Even everything was fine. Your wisdom will be remembered and eternalized. And the words of encouragement and comfort you gave to me at times when I thought I was feeling scared or worthless will be a powerful reminder that I am loved, cherished, and born into this world for a reason. You give me the strength to overcome and persevere. And I look at what you and Mom have brought immersion into the world. Four kids who stand proud on who they become. I see myself with a creative mind. I see my sister brimming with talent. I see my older brother lucrative and savvy. I see my younger brother steadfast and anime. All bright and level-headed, prepared to take on what life throws at them. I hope you are happy and proud of their heaven, because you deserve to be. I say now what should have been voiced, what was held in our hearts infinitely more. Thank you for everything. We love you, Dad.
My brother also said he's not good with words, but he did extremely well. Now we are going to the office of the baby of the house. St. Patrick, the man with Afro hair. Over to you, sir.
Power to change your face. No.
Never in my life did I feel more powerless than in the face of loss. Countless times I pondered the possibility, yet never could I imagine it. And now, I don't have to. I have lost you. But you are far from gone. Your will is everlasting and your soul coincides with ours, offering guidance in our times of need, amidst the anguish, the same guidance that will lead us towards a glimmer of hope. And the very same guidance you provided in your time here on earth. That hope signifies your impact as a father, who has laid the foundation for a man you can be proud of and allow me to experience a life as satiety as you have. You may rest easy knowing that you not only lived as a remarkable role model, but will be forever engraved in my memory as a brilliant teacher. Bestowed upon me solemn gratitude for the life I am blessed with, courtesy of you, Dad, one of your greatest contributors. Me, of course.
These young, energetic, proud Nigerians to our delicious family. Thank you all so much. I am so proud of all of you. And I'm also proud of your dad because Olo tap recurrent from his strength. Also Jerome. Thank you, Rico. I am proud of you. I am proud of your father. And I'm proud of what the family has become. Yeah. Russia, Oga, Papa, all I have. I'm not a lion. And he happened to be a son of Akaland, a member of the family, an attorney by profession, a friend, and in law. Every time I get you, look at that one.
Let me start by thanking every one of you tonight that came here to mourn and live with us. Thank you so much. Let me also pray that we do not reciprocate this kindness of yours by coming to an event of this circumstance. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
December 2023, all of us as a family will proceed to Nigeria. We celebrated like we have never celebrated before. My cousin, J-Lo, as I fondly call him, and he called me Lion, as if he's the one that gave me that name. All of us were there. We went from chieftaincy to parties, to marriage ceremony parties. We celebrated, we drank, we had fun. 2 days after our arrival, there was this news of the mother-in-law's death. We were still grieving over that one. And when I met him at the last party, which is the marriage ceremony, I said to my brother, okay, what I will do is when I get back to the United States, I will come and see you over the death of your mother-in-law. And he left the United States, hurrying back to prepare for the burial of the mother-in-law. And I want to arrive Dulles. As usual, the pilot will tell you to get ready, we're about to land. My brother woke up, went to the restroom, only for the hell to break loose. All the doctors in the airplane, everybody scrambled for solution. Of course, we know the results. My friends, my brothers, that is the reality of Mrs. Ijoma Anibe and our family today. You know, a lot of people, the Reverend Fathers, they will tell you, don't ask a question. You know, I went the kind of school I went to, we asked too many questions. You begin to make sense out of this. You begin to rationalize it. Then of course they come with a good English explanation. Let us leave it in the hands of and will and raise the nation of God. My brother, it's time to ask him the question. Why not the that which is good to you, you must make it sound and good to me. Jello is, I don't know, of course, maybe every one of us have met in Jello before. He's the kindest, the most kindest, generous, selfless individual you can deal with. This event today, if Jello is alive, he'll be the first person to be in this hall. If there was money to be donated, Jello will be the first person to donate that money. This is who he is. And of course, I know that is why every one of you are here. Because you know him. So, you know, I was speaking to one of my good friends today, this afternoon. And when I told him what happened, do you know what he said to me? He said, if this is the way to die, it is better for death to let us know. So that the Ibrahim got another than Beyakam and do it for him. Because, so the question is, what is the joy to life? Let me tell you, the joy to life is not that aeroplane you bought for yourself. It is the etiquette this my younger one will buy for the father at the age of 70 and says, Daddy, come over. I want to celebrate you. That is what life is all about. Not this dying young. At the time you begin to say, okay, let me sit down and watch my children grow. Let me see what they would be. Let me see the position that we attain in the society. It is time for you to tell me that I'm going to go home to put my brother to the ground. My brother, can you imagine that? I pray I don't visit you for under these circumstances. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
Yes, big cats, the lions don't show emotion. But what they do is deep and painful. Take out my brother. Lion, take out. Because I have one more slot. This slot is given to a man that I call Double. It's two in one. We added two people together to make one person. We took Joe. We added Ben to it, and we made it Joe Ben. My brother Joe and Ben, please, two in one. The slot is for you. Over to you, sir.
This is hard to follow. Death is something that we don't plan for. If you plan for it, I wonder if you had a hand in what happened to the person. So, having said that, I often said, none of us, nobody here is promised tomorrow. If we must continue to pray that we live a longer life. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, there's no way in 1,000 years that we would imagine that he will be gone so soon. We were with him in July, in November. With him on a different occasion in December. Again, we went to on a medical mission to Nigeria. We were with him and his family. This generous couple hosted us And if you have not experienced before what it means to host a team of medical mission, ladies and gentlemen, please, it is not something to sniff at.
You know that fact, I'm going to call the brother, my in-law, to also come here to share with us the biography of Mama. Is in there, hold on. One day I'm having a book time, Mama, I didn't make a mistake. Sir, Moses, Uzaba, Biko, the one who wrote Ubasa Mama, over to my brother. Biko, Umanamo, Umanamo, Uman, I am a little beer with gentleman. But I am going to a person. I would not have my head, I don't say, I'm not good, I'm not good, I'm not good. But for the fact that this our brother is gentle to the core. Can you find an old day who don't be the one before Yala? Or I don't know what because I'm a devil in there, and I don't want to have them at the black. Oh, because I got not all out one by one. I got my dream there, but if you push me to do that, I will. Because I'm not going to them. Oh, yeah, I'm not going to them. I'm how gentle people like me. And I had no button. Rikolo, I'm quite a humble. My brother, Moses, over to you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Actually, we are supposed to gather here this evening to celebrate my mother. Yeah. I'm not to warn you. We want to make this occasion a good one before all these tragic incidents happened or occurred. We are all together in December, December 1st, to be precise. The first meeting we had for the burial of my mother, we are all together in the village. My in-law promised, I know he mentioned how many cows he was going to buy to give his mother-in-law a befitting burial. That was the 1st of January. On the 6th of January, he was gone. We don't know why. He was not just an in-law, but a brother and a friend. The best in-law that any one would decide to have. He gave my sister here every opportunity to excel in whatever capacity, whatever level, whatever field with Ochoro. He stood behind her. We felt him as a brother. We felt his impact on our family, as a mentor and as a friend. I don't know. But whatever happens, we give thanks to God. We can't question God. This is the biography of our mother, Ezinne Hoda Amariwuba Ekomaro Zawa. Life, in the words of the teacher, is meaningless and utterly meaningless. It's vanity upon vanity, all is vanity. Ezinne Hoda Amariwuba Ekomaro Zawa was born in the year 1935 into the royal family of Eze Nkem Kona of in the old Oturuku village in Otura, now Ezio, and it's only about the most community in Ibitulogman area. Having lost her mother at a tender age of 5, she was taken to Lagos by her elder brother, led His Royal Highness Eze Eloha Nkemka in 1951. Mama came back and enrolled into the central school, it's only about for her primary education. On completion of primary education, she was attracted to let Mr. Charles Nana Ekomaro Zaba, who was then a school teacher and equally a church teacher residing in Port Harcourt, River State. Mama was later enrolled into the YWCA Onusha, where she did a two years program in domestic science under the guidance of Bishop Mwege of blessed memory. That program was necessary and compulsory for intending priests and church teachers' wives. On completion of her course, Mama got married and wedded to late Charles Nane Komando Zaba in April 16, 1956 at St. Thomas Church in Zamobiato. Thereafter, Mama followed her husband to Port Harcourt to start a new life as a couple. While in Port Harcourt, she was committed to church activities, especially the women ministry, and as a domestic scientist. The women ministry benefited from her wealth of experience. Mama enrolled into the Anglican Mothers Union in 1957 at the St. Peter's Anglican Church, Isiogo. It is noteworthy to mention that Mama was the first woman to be enrolled into Mothers Union in the Eastern Bethel Parish. Mama assisted her husband in training or bringing of her children until the outbreak of the Civil War in 1967, when they left all they had in Port Harcourt and relocated back home. Back home, she joined the women ministry and held several leadership positions, both in the state, in the station, parish, and actually county levels. Mama also made her mark in the service of her community. She was the chairlady of Fugok and Women Association for a period of 18 years. She was the chairperson, president of EOTU Women Wing Home and Abroad for 3 years, during which she coordinated a federal government poverty alleviation program, Better Life Program for rural women, through the help of the chairman of the then Bitoli Local Area, Chief Onyebodi. Mama was able to attract the garri processing machines to the community, among other things. Mama headed several developmental committees in the community. She was indeed a community leader. Following the death of her husband in March 1992, Mama retired from active community leadership and focused on raising her family with 9 children. A task that the cold hands of death had left for her in the hands alone, for her to handle alone. As a vicious and courageous mother, the death of her husband did not deter her from taking up the mantle of leadership of her family. She was multidimensional in her daily activities, in her efforts to fulfill the vision of her husband in making sure that their children went to school. A businesswoman, farmer, and oil palm producer whose entrepreneurial acumen could not be matched. Mama was blessed in all endeavors, a role model of motherhood, and a great homemaker. Today, all her 9 children are all married and all doing well in their respective areas of endeavors. Mama's activities did not end here in the rural area. She has visited the USA 3 times. Where she spent time with her last daughter, Mrs. Darlene Anibel, and the family. Since she came back, Mama has been an advisor, patron, consultant to all organizations, a philanthropist, a role model who has bagged several awards both in the church and the community, among which are the Ezine Adaiziama Awards, ETC. As Mama is laid to rest, we exhalate the fact that she lived an impactful, sacrificial, purposeful, and Christian life, and was a mother to all, and we pray for her soul to rest in perfect peace. Amen. Thank you. Survived by Mrs. Seba Chimezeodora, Chief Sir Dennis Nozawa son, Mrs. Ethel Ozoma Dora, Dr. Sir Ethel Ozoma son, Lord Dr. Ijoma Anibe Dora, Mr. Ochen Ozoma son, Mr. Mabez Ekomaro son, Sir Moses Ekomaro son, Sir Chima Ekomaro son, son-in-law, Led Chief Nawihe Chimezie, Mr. Stephen Ezenwa, Led Chief Prince Jude Anibe, daughters-in-law, Lady Dr. Ngozi Ozawa, Lady Ihamatina Ozawa, Mrs. Ijoma Ozawa, Mrs. Stella Ojuge Komaro, Lady Zulu Sylvia Komaro, Lady Ogeda Majuge Komaro, 31 grandchildren, 17 great-grandchildren, and 3 great-great-grandchildren. Thank you.
Yes.
sir. Thank you so much, my brother. Thank you.
Everybody give their tribute, so I might have just thrown in my little tribute also. That way, I see him there. Okay, please, this is a tribute to my loving brother, Chief Fitz Judah, Chidi Ayinjo, for Kassim Nanyurugo, one of whom I can Asian Kingdom. Oh, Prince, where are you? Where do we begin to search? Where do we begin to mourn the mournable? And where do we begin to grieve for the ungrievable? Death has shot by the fans. Death had merciless at their judgment. He had dipped their claws to the garden of life and plucked the golden apple. And they remember the last time we, the mother boy, sat down to discuss our niece's wedding and the plans we made on how to honor her. Now how was I to know that in a few weeks our world would turn upside down to the terrible and shocking news of your passing? I do, I love brother, Chief Priest Duke Anibe, or Kasima, the one of Nakeshin Kingdom. Their passing has left a big hole in the fabric of our reality. The plans uncompleted, the dreams unfulfilled. Their dynamic and loving nature will be greatly missed. My children speak of their loving uncle, look to them everywhere, and show them love before to their fathers. Stories from cousins who you took under your wing and protected during your primary school days. A pound of plenty. You have been a great sounding board to me, and your pieces of advice have been immeasurable in effectiveness. I remember your graduation from the University of the University of Columbia, Washington, D.C., and how proud of momentous dotation was because you were the thought I needed to graduate from that distinguished school of great learning. And of course, by growing up, I found plenty, the power I wish. I will share it here with you right now. What I do know is that your passing is a big blow to the family, but you must thank the Almighty God for allowing us and granting us the gift of enjoying your life and being part of it. You are a beloved son, a brother, a husband, father, uncle, and friends to a multitude. You will be deeply missed, but your memory will live on the hearts of all who love you. May you rest in eternal peace. In Jesus' name. The good book says that if the good comes, give glory to the Almighty God, and if the bad comes, give him glory too. We thank him for his gift of you to the world, and now that he has called you home, we commend your spirit into his loving care for eternal peace for rest. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Sweet.
Chassis one of Umaga, Asian kingdom. Even though you are saying to your father's home, this is your day. And but for you, we will not be here. You are a devoted Christian, a good uniform officer by your career, a caring father to all that you call your own. You did the good you could. But for you, we are here. Again, a good uniform officer by your career. You did the good you can by all the means you could. In all the ways you could. In all the places you could. At the times you could. Doctor. Lord of Ijoma Naime, we are here to say to you, accept our condolences. May God richly bless you and your family.
I'm going to make it brief, just to say on behalf of everybody standing from the Department of Public Safety, we are also members of one of the largest unions in the United States, that is American Federation of States, County Municipal Employee. On behalf of that, we're going to present a token to the family of Sergeant Chief Adek.
Exited us without notice, and then we feel so very bad about it. Therefore, we are only mourning, not celebrating, but we have to cap it up with a presentation of a token for the wife and the family to one of their peers. I'm hereby calling on Mr. Abu Desi, who is the person designated to present our check, to present the check to the family. Why is it happening?
Thank you so much, Chief Mangu. Our age-long president, we miss him so much. I've been designated, like they said, without a president, I've been designated to present this token.
So I'm using this opportunity to extend my condolences to the family of Chief Jude Anibe and the entire DOC members who have represented us.
Yes, sir. All the ones
of Jesus.
Lord,
appreciate
you.
Oh, my soul every day.
Oh yes, sir. It was that women association.
It's not a good feeling. But you know what though? We are always there for our friends. That's why we are called United Friends. So, Dr. Ijoma, you know, when I met you and Chief, it was a blessing. Chief was, once he got into our organization, he was so involved. And you guys got so involved, and in our last boat ride, you helped organize the boat ride. So say to you, on your behalf, I hand this envelope. Because honorable members, UFI don't kiss and tell.
We don't
kiss and tell.
General is not paying attention.
Okay. Because for everybody here, when you hear about UFI, we do not kiss and tell. Okay, Joma, we love you. You're always going to be a member of UFI. Whether Chief is here or Chief is there, whatever, you're going to continue to respect Chief, you're going to continue to honor Chief, and you're always going to be a member of UFI. God bless you going forward. We're going to be with you. Thank you.
Our first national lady here, Lord, it is you, Zebu. Would they run here and will pass? Yes, President Emeritus. Yes, the Congress, members of the board, let's extend it. Our U.S. National Parliamentarian, yes, our council. I recognize already civil, already Sicaria, not invulnerable, not invulnerable. Yes. And of course, my lovely wife, Dr. Mrs. Chimwendu Okoro. Why him won't be here? Why him won't be here? Why to 25? Only we won't be here. Yes, already is in the house. Rose Lover, yes, Dr. Hassan, me Dr. Gary Akari, I salute you, my beautiful sister Lima. Dr. Mrs. Chow, I salute you. I'm proud of you. My dream one. Come over here, that will happen. Hey, Black, come and take the microwave. All right, U.S. National in the house. I would like to call the National Bureau. I would like to call Lalo, Princess. Lalo, Princess, Gigi, all the way from Dallas, our national bureau to please do us the honor to usher in our national delegates, to usher in our national delegates, the national bureau, Princess, all the way from Dallas, in the house. Oh yes, the princess herself, my two-in-one, beauty, they're gonna be the national PRO, take over from me and usher in our national delegate, please.
Our president, the Daddy, Costa, will call for Harry in the house. doctor. What could you present the best?
USA, I Bella, if I grab one night, okay, we'll go. Chief, Prince, Jude, Chidi, and Ibe, all my for Maka. Everybody can do Lano, and my Maka, the chicken. Because they are USA, I could change him. So, some DC will be not here.
What you want, man? What camera maka one? Hello, real here. All the way from New York. We go my room. How can I forget my own titulante? Titulante. National First Lady, and she is from Ora DC, of course. She is from Ora DC, Titi Lente, the First Lady, Ora USA, representing the husband.
But that's my brother-in-law also, Chief Prince Anime. We can have got the second of Umaka. Oh, my name, bro. But I got one guy who go to lane. Us here, the woman, for my name, Rodara. Everybody come up with them.
All right. All right. May we never come to this kind of event anytime soon again, in Jesus' name. But guess what? Tonight, we all need to show why every Olu son and daughter should belong to Ora USA. If you're a member, Iwoye Olu, please come out here and show love for the family of the departed. Mr. DJ, I want those today that are not from Olu to see what Ora USA is all about. Let's show love for our brother and family. Honorable Piaro and TST, you take the mic and do what you do best. Later, our VP will speak on our behalf.
Thank you. My boss, about TST, social demonstrator.
Oh yes, I gladly celebrate my friend, my brother, my secretary when I was the board chairman, Chief Prince Jude Anime. He served me as my secretary when I was the board chairman. When I took over as patron, my gentle giant, my good friend, yes, my brother. All the way from New Jersey, Yara Anthony, Chichi, Kasalebo, Bakacha, Odebu, Yara, Brother, oh yes, okay, so here we say, I'm a son of a boy, yes, I'm a bunch of pack, I'm a day, all New Jersey, first lady. Oh yes, from Ora DC.
That is.
Hey.
Ora DC board member.
Oh yes. To Mama and Oba.
A wind player. A servant of his people. The person of Prince. Chief. Jude. Chief. And you. We are presenting this flag so that you will go home and hang it. And to be a reminder of the father you have.
Already see presenting a plaque.
So the posthumous service award in recognition of his selfless service to RDC in many capacities, we solemnly present this service award posthumously to Chief Prince
Jude, Jade, and Yibi. You are bearing him as a true warrior, even as he is no longer with us. May his family be eternally consoled. Dated today, this day, 10th of April 2024. Signed by Christopher Siusuku, President, and Sir Jobin Olero, Vice President. So keep this as a reminder of the service of the government.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I will move this thing for the concerning innocence of the speaker. And me and your disposal, you know.
Thank you so much.
USA. Bigo Munde, Atrom Konya Braganti to our young and dynamic Vice President of our USA. Omen Amayo, Yamanya microphone, I'm going to talk in Shebe Igbo language. So Bigo Konya Braganti to Prince Charles Duru, National Vice President of our USA.
Yeah, I know the family. We don't lose your mother, but we don't lose your own. My kind of values, Omwen, is still with you guys. Those values is the testimony of what you guys shared. And I encourage each and every one of you to continue to live that legacy. Okay, God will be with you.
Yeah.
I be with Ringa, Ora USA and Abambo is support to the member in Yemen. Chief Benike gave one or two words, but I have a Ora USA family assistant program.
Thank you.
Oh God, my God, my God.
I got to know.
One of Umuahia and the souls of all the faithful departed through the mercy of God. Rest in peace.
I'm not Support her and may the Lord be with you. When you go bury your husband. May the Lord Almighty go with you. The bad people will not see you. All the devils will not see you. Whatever kind of society they have out there, they will not see you. The Lord will blind them. You will go there, celebrate your husband, bury him, give him the defeating burial, and come back home in Jesus' name.
We have a little token for our sister. So I want her to come in and get the envelope.
Oh, okay, we are giving it to one of the children, all right? Yes, we be give this to your mom. This is our grace of what? Alright? Just a token. Whatever we put in this envelope, we never bring your dad. But it's just to support our sister, okay? And support you guys. So be strong and support your mom, alright? Don't leave her behind. She needs you guys at this hard time, alright? Thank you all very much. Principal sisters, you guys turn up in a great number. I am so proud of you all. Thank you all very much.
Oh,
Thank you, my brother.
To mourn and celebrate our God. our humble brother, Chief Prince Joe Anime Ochachi, one of Omaga. Ochachi, one of Omaga. Ladies and gentlemen, words are inadequate to express our profound gratitude for what you people have done to come all the way from far and wide to come and join us. People from California, people from every part of the world here this night, we are so thankful to all of you. And we are thanking Almighty God to safely take you people home whenever your branch is. All this we ask you through the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are with you, one God forever and ever. Amen.
We thank thee each morning for a newborn day, where we may work the fields of new-mown hay. We thank thee for the sunshine and the air that we breathe, O Lord. We thank thee. Thank thee for the rivers that run all day. Thank thee for the little birds that sing along the way. Thank thee for the trees and the deep blue sea, O Lord. We thank thee. Oh yes, we thank thee, Lord, for every flower that blooms, birds that sing, fish that swim, and the light of the moon. We thank thee every day as we kneel and pray, that we were born with eyes to see these things. Thank thee for the fields where the clover is grown. Thank thee for the pastures where cattle may roam. Thank thee for thy love so pure and free, O Lord. We thank thee. Oh yes, we thank thee, Lord, for every flower that blooms, birds that sing, fish that swim, and the light of the moon. We thank thee every day as we kneel and pray, that we were born with eyes to see these things. Yes, we thank thee for the fields where the clover is grown. Thank thee for the pastures where cattle may roam. Thank thee for thy love so pure and so free, O Lord. We thank thee.